on the tape, bro.
Is it blown?
No,
you're good. You're good. All right.
Ready?
Yep. So this new space we just grabbed, it's up front in the entrance to the business park. What's been difficult as we've grown is when we first grabbed our first suite here, we were the first business to grab a unit here. I mean, when we moved in, this parking lot was still dirt. We were the first people to run internet into this building. And then as this area grew so much, now there's like no space left, which in retrospect, I wish we would have grabbed more space in the beginning. The issue is, well, we couldn't afford it in the beginning. So we grabbed our first 10,000 square feet, then we grabbed another 10,000 square feet, then we grabbed another 5,000 square feet, and we grabbed 20,000 square feet on the back side of the business park. And we went to the landlord about 45 days ago. We said, Ken, we need more space. And he said, Nick, I got nothing. We're like, oh shit. So finally something opened up, which is just 2,800 square feet of office and warehouse, but we're converting it to just all be office, and we're gonna move our marketing department there and our executive team there because we need more office space. And we've now maxed out this business park for what's available. The next move after all of our leases are up, because we have about two years left on our leases, is we're going to work with the landlord to build something that we either rent from him or we own, and everything's under one house where offices are in one spot, operations and warehouses in another, gyms in another, because right now we're kind of playing Tetris to just make it work. But let's show you the new spot. So fun fact about me, if you didn't know, I love interior design. I love it. So when I walk into this place, I see a blank canvas where there's so much that we can do. And when I plan, like when we take over a new space, I kind of buy things as I go and I see how it fits and how it looks, and I build off of it and I move things around. So this office space is gonna have a very different feel than the other office spaces. I'm just trying something new. This room right here is going to be a Zoom room. So we'll have a TV, small conference table, and a camera, because one of the issues that the marketing and executive team is experiencing right now is there's just too much noise. Like everyone's on calls all the time. So having one room that's just dedicated to Zoom calls and meetings will be perfect. The finance team, so like our CFO, VP of finance, will be in this room right here. We're gonna use this open space as a conference room. So we'll have like an 85-inch TV on that wall right there, a huge 120-inch table. And then coming in here, now, big issue in here is it was being used for like industrial space. We're gonna be using it for office space. You might be able to hear as soon as I walk in here. I gotta find some sort of solution because as soon as you walk in, it echoes. I'm like, I don't think you can make a room any more echoey. So I'm trying to find solutions right now to solve for this, but we're gonna have kind of open concept desks and working areas in here. But this right here is a blank canvas. Literally, I can do so much with this. I just inquired with this company here in Austin, Texas to ship out this entire wall. This will be to date my biggest piece of shiplap, depending on how much it's gonna cost, but all shiplap. And this is the new space. It's got AC, it's got heat. Only thing I can say, blank canvas, and I'm about to paint my creativity all over the shiplap. Man, my phone freezes all the time.
Truck smells so bad. Are you coming
inside?
Yeah,
taking inside. Every time it rains, my truck smells like a wet dog. We're gonna put the heat on, a little sauna action.
Same temperature as that room.
I gotta grab some rugs really quick. So we had some rugs delivered today. We had two tables delivered that I'll put together. And then once Wi-Fi is installed, the acoustic panels are in, and the security system is set up, we'll move that team to the new spot, and then we'll shuffle people in the building. I mean, right now we just have people kind of spread all over the place because we're max capacity for office space, and we need more of it. I ain't here for a long time, but I'm here for a good time. Somebody doesn't like to buckle their seatbelt.
Way later.
Rugs USA is where it's at. I mean, there's people who spend $20,000 on rugs. $200.
Oh, wow. Even $200. Well,
ooh. Now, I've bought my fair share of rugs in the day. There's nothing worse than a shedding rug.
I remember this. Didn't you return like the next day?
Yes. I honestly don't understand why they would even make the shit.
Very interesting color what you got going on with this one.
Dude, the thing is, wait till all the furniture goes down. You gotta get rugs that have like contrasting colors. It's a vibe.
Fade real quick, hold on.
No! I'm not serious.
Just lay it down. To be honest, I don't even know why I brought a screwdriver over. You know they're gonna make you put it together with an Allen key.
My dad did. Cut off the bend part.
Ah, that's smart.
Stick that Allen key right into the drill bit. You're done. Oh, there we go.
You're in?
Yeah.
I think I'm in. No, I'm not in.
There, I'm in.
I'm in, I think.
Oh, wait.
Oh, I think I'm in.
I'm in, I think.
Yeah, I'm in.
There we go. I'm in now. Shut up, you.
I'm using all this audio and then we're giving me the video. This is how the video starts. I'm in. Are you in? I'm in. All right, they're writing. Oh. That's hilarious.
That's great.
How has your day been going so far?
It's going really good. I showed up to work. We laughed. I got a free rug.
I'm going to need you to gather your things and get the fuck out.
Take the rug with you.
Thanks for helping me put the table together. Now gather your shit.
Yeah. I'm talking about, can you keep the rug and can I get a severance package instead?
Great table. Bam. Send a photo to the team. The TV's massive, it's 85 inch, but in this photo it looks tiny. Doesn't do it justice.
It never does.
No. Send this to Kat and Josh.
Josh is gonna be like, how much was that TV?
Bam. Josh gave me a budget to build this whole spot out. I'm gonna be way under budget.
Wait. We should talk about who Josh is because we're going to reference him a lot. I feel like
Josh, our CFO, he gave me a budget to build this whole spot out. I'm going to be so under budget. I'm being resourceful. I'm about to blow his mind. I mean, I might hit like half of his budget that he gave me for this spot. Easy. Paint, rugs, shiplap, furniture, TVs, you're good.
All right, so here's the deal. So we're 6 days out. On August 29th, we're going to San Antonio, and we're meeting with HEB. which is super exciting. So BPN predominantly is a direct-to-consumer business. So the really cool thing about this is an opportunity for us to launch into retail. So we did just launch with Central Market in 10 stores, and then HEB has 390 stores throughout Texas.
What would this mean for BPN if we got this?
I think the biggest thing that we're looking at is we get to tap into an entirely new audience. There's obviously going to be overlap between our current direct-to-consumer, our current consumer base, but with retail, you touch people who haven't come across the brand because maybe they're not as digitally native as our current customer base. I think the biggest thing for BPN is this brand can succeed both as a direct-to-consumer brand as well as a retail brand. And so the big thing with launching in retail is proving that, hey, this isn't just D2C, this can be an omni-channel brand that has success in retail. And so the really cool thing is BPN is obviously native to Texas, and everyone's favorite grocery store is HEB. So this is like a really cool way for BPN to align with a brand that is so ingrained in like Texas identity. So I think that's what's super exciting. And then this really is just like the tip of the iceberg for retail. If we decide, hey, we wanna keep leaning into retail and we wanna open up new doors, maybe it is something that like we could explore a Whole Foods. Maybe it is something that we could explore a Costco contract. Maybe it is something that we could go to more regional grocers like Publix, maybe. So this is just like a really great, honestly, test for the brand to see how we take a brand that's online and translate it into retail and to see how we convert. So it's a good test for the team, and it's a really good test for our operational capacity. And so we're just kind of excited to get the ball rolling and see what happens.
So we just checked into the visitor center, officially checked in. BPN team, Nick Bear, Kat Thomas. And now we are driving over to where we are meeting the buyer for HEB. So a few weeks ago, Kat and I drove to Dallas. We met with the buyer for Central Market, presented the BPN brand and product offering to be in all 10 Central Market stores. And that went very well. And as of today, we are now in all Central Market stores, which has been amazing news and great progress for the BPN team and family. Today, we are presenting BPN to the HEB buyer, which is a lot larger than Central Market. To put into perspective, Central Market was 10 stores. How many HEB stores are there?
I believe 390 and growing.
There are about 390 HEB stores. The goal today is just to get BPN into HEB. Obviously, it'd be amazing if they introduced us to all 390 stores. We're not going into that with that expectation. We just would like to be able to show what we can do in HEB. Let us show and prove our velocity with the brand. And then if successful, the goal is to be in all HEB stores shortly, but today is that first step forward.
A big thing along this journey is obviously BPN is primarily a D2C business. And the really neat thing about expanding into retail is a lot of people are of the expectation that by expanding into retail, you cannibalize your e-commerce business. But reality is when you expand into retail, you actually acquire a new customer base. And so we're super excited because HEB has 390 stores, but that's 390 stores that are hyper located within Texas. So HEB is a regional grocery store, whereas as opposed to a national grocery store chain. So to have 390 stores all based in Texas, where 14% of our current consumer base is, it's a really great opportunity for BPN to lean into its roots, lean into Texas, and you know, give a new customer an opportunity to engage with the brand. So we're stoked.
All right, should we go in?
Yeah. Bye, Yuli.
Bye, I'll see you soon.
Well, it went well. Let me update you in a little bit. Oh, you got your peach.
I got my peach, that's what I'm waiting for.
Good.
It's really juicy.
That one's juicier than mine is.
Okay. Update. We pitched to the buyers, the BPN brand, the story. Yoli, I even told them a story about how you got started.
Nice. They loved it.
They loved it.
Really?
Yep. And they're doing a reset right now, which means they're looking at all the brands and products they currently offer. And they're looking at all the brands and products they want to bring in. Over the next couple weeks, they're having meetings just like the one we had right now. And they're going to decide in a few weeks who they bring on and who they take away. But after that meeting, they loved BPN. They loved the story. They loved the mission. They loved the fact that we have a big Texas community and following, especially 14% of our orders coming from Texas. I would say, based off the questions they asked, there's a good chance that, like Kat was saying, we might not get as many SKUs into HEB as we've got in the central market, but I think we're going to get a lot of stores. They asked the question, how many stores could we facilitate if they place a production order? We said all of them.
We said all of them.
Obviously. I mean, that went.
That was great.
That went great. That went as good as it could go.
Yeah.
Honestly.
We're in a good spot.
So now we just wait.
Say some prayers. And see what happens.
But it looks like March. March is when they...
March is a rollout.
They would roll us out. And we push for all stores, brand block, and a rollout within a week rather than piecemealing. So this literally could be revolutionary for BPN, like life-changing for the trajectory of where the company's heading and what happens in the next 12 months.
Absolutely. I think the brand block would be clutch. We sold them on a brand block, Yuli. So this idea of you don't just take the whey protein and then you sit it next to the competitor's whey protein, and then you take the hydration product and it sits next to a competitor's hydration product. You put all the products side by side in a singular block. So when you buy a greens and then you had a great experience, then you go back and you buy another BPN product. So the goal there is really to help drive new trial for customers, and also really to retain that customer and just have their average cart value increase. So they really liked that. They said that'd be super unique for them to do, but they also hinted at if they would do it, it would probably be for someone like BPN, which was cool. So really sweet ladies.
Amazing.
Amazing ladies.
Amazing ladies.
Worked there for over 30 years. Everyone who's been there worked 27 years, 31 years, 33 years, 30 years. They're about like the same way that the BPN community buys in the BPN, like their employees have bought into HEB, which is really cool to see.
Yeah.
Really nice people too.
Now we wait, time will tell. Time will tell.
That's so sick. To the moon.
I need this out here, I'm ripping everywhere. Baby, baby, oh. So we're kicking off this morning with a 5-mile run, and right now what I'm calling my training is the hybrid build. So we've placed a huge emphasis back on strength training, strength and size, increased calories, decreased weekly running mileage. Right now, weekly running mileage is anywhere from 15 to 25 miles max. But one thing I'm finding is I'm a whole lot more tight, like sore tight in upper body, lower body, because I'm hitting strength training so hard right now. But we're still putting miles in. That is part of the hybrid training lifestyle. Gotta keep running. So 5 miles this morning. So I got something for you guys, and it's all about hard work and entitlement. What I see all too often is that people think just because you put in hard work that you are entitled to success. You're entitled to a win. You're entitled to a PR. You're entitled to everything. Hard work, that is the bare minimum of entry. You have to wake up every single day implementing MREs, the minimum required effort. When you wake up and you put in the minimal required effort every single day, you might not see the result right away. And if you're hoping for it, and if you're disappointed that it doesn't come, what you're feeling is entitlement. That's what that is. What you're seeing right now is the MRE of waking up every single day for the last decade, putting in work in terms of business, building teams, relationships, fitness, diet, nutrition. Do not allow the thought, the perception of hard work to turn into an entitlement, because that is the death of you. Five miles, 37 minutes, 13 seconds, 7:26 minute per mile pace. So right now at BPN, we are implementing EOS, which is the Entrepreneurial Operating System. If you've read the book Traction, you probably know what EOS is, or if you operate in a highly effective organization, you might have EOS implemented into your company. Within EOS, you set 90-day rocks, which are your objectives. And there's one way to measure success for these 90-day rocks and these objectives, and that's data, it's numbers. If we look at growth, a lot of people will refer to growth in terms of being subjective. I think I grew over the last 12 months. I think our business grew over the last quarter. I think I got better at running. I think I got stronger. The only way to really measure progress and growth is with objective data and numbers. So put numbers to what you're doing. You should be able to look back at the last month, the last quarter, the last year. Did your business grow in terms of objective data and numbers? Did your income increase? Did you implement systems for multiple streams of revenue? Did you get faster? Did you get stronger? Did you get leaner? Use objective data to measure growth. It is not subjective. And if you're falling back on subjective feelings to determine growth, man, you are holding yourself back tremendously.
All the screw, a bunch of gear.
How she is?
Yeah.
Nice.
She's like
So if you guys didn't know, we are super excited to announce that BPN products are in Central Market stores. So there are 10 Central Market grocery stores in the Texas area. We have a few in Austin, there's one in San Antonio, in Dallas, and we're super excited to start moving BPN products into retail. So we're going to the Central Market Austin store on North Lamar right now. We're filling up the BPN truck. We're gonna check out the brand block and we're gonna try to find the manager, talk to the manager about how we can help activate our partnership, hosting events, pop-ups, doing workouts around that Central Market here in North Lamar. So just trying to build this relationship. And that's what we're kind of leading into with our retail partnership expansion, is we want to build relationships at the store level. It's one thing to build a relationship at the Central Market retail level, but we want to build relationships at the actual store level with the people stocking shelves, people who are selling the products, working the cash registers, and just working at that store. So that's the goal for today. It's tearing up my heart when I'm with you. So we got right here is a box for, well, the plan is to go inside, try to find the manager or the assistant manager, and then give them a box of goodies, try to win them over. Got some field bars, some protein, some pre-workout, some greens, some reds, shaking hands and kissing babies. Shaking babies and kissing hands. Something like that.
Who are we kissing?
Kissing you.
All right.
We went to film the blood work yesterday. I was like, hey man, can we film this? We're filming for a YouTube video. He's like, absolutely not. Here, we'll go here, maybe.
You wanna find him first?
Yeah, let's find him first.
All
right. Oh yeah. Hi.
Hi.
It would be funny if I just went and found an intercom and I was like, manager to the front, manager to the front. Oh, it's this young lady right here. Maybe this is not the most efficient way to do it.
Probably not. You know, I wasn't gonna say anything, but no, this is definitely, this is the worst way to go about it, I think.
Hey, is this lady right here?
Look at this face. Look at these muscles.
Hi.
They're functional, they serve a purpose.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hey.
Are you the manager?
I am one of the managers.
So, my name's Nick. I'm the founder and owner of Bear Performance Nutrition. And then, if we wanted to do some activations and campaigns with the store, maybe like samplings in the store, or we have a large online following. Hey, what's up, man?
How's it
going? How you doing?
I'm gonna say hi.
Oh, thanks, man. Appreciate you.
I'm running the protein now, so I got a marathon in December.
So. Oh, congrats. Good luck, man.
Dude.
So we have a lot of people that follow the brand.
Yeah.
Probably that guy right there.
That was not a plan.
our goal is to be your best performing supplement company in Central Market. Well, great. That's all good news.
Yeah.
And you said we can just call the store?
Yeah, absolutely.
Or, okay.
So that was successful. We talked to the manager. We set up our first in-store demo, which is gonna be the end of this month, September 30th, in the Central Market store, North Lamar, for about 3 hours. And as you can see right here, the BPN brand block is on display. So we told the manager that it is our goal, it's our objective, to be the best performing sports nutrition and health supplement company in all Central Market stores. But it's actually amazing to see products in retail, and not only in retail, but in retail doing well with high velocity, meaning they're moving off the shelves. It's amazing to see, absolutely amazing. So if you have a Central Market store close to you, what I'm asking you to please do is go to that Central Market store and buy BPN products. That helps prove our success, prove our velocity in retail, and it's gonna help build that partnership. So if you go to the Central Market store, you buy the products, make sure to take a photo, tag me on Instagram, I will reshare it, the BPN team will reshare it, and we wanna make sure these products are moving off the shelves faster, they can be restocked. So thank you guys for all the support. Without you guys, this would not be possible.